How the lack of trust in AI healthcare could dwarf a pandemic. What is artificial intelligence or AI? It's a science of programming machines to do cognitive tasks that humans do, like decision-making through machine learning, visual perception through computer vision, language understanding through NLP or natural language processing. All around us, we often see AI working behind the scenes, like when you shop online, or when you stream media, or when you drive, or when you interact with others on a social network. Among the many applications of AI, healthcare is particularly significant because it touches everyone. It is also socially critical and a sensitive area. Here are some examples of how AI is used in healthcare. Image analysis is used in radiology to identify tumors. Analytics is used for chronic care management. Classification is used for checking symptoms of the patient and helps doctors with clinical diagnosis. Robotics is used to deliver care. Genomics is used for individualized care. Transfer learning is used for self-care, prevention, and wellness. Materials informatics is used for drug development. Chatbots are used for mental health therapy, and so on. And all these examples are just scratching the surface of so many other possibilities. AI provides many benefits. For example, doctors can diagnose and treat patients from anywhere in the world. Patients can have 24/7 monitoring. The technology also lowers the cost of care. Patients can be given customized care. Patients have increased access to care, and many more. So let's look at the increased access to care in a little more detail. A lot of people in developed and developing nations can get access to healthcare using AI. Access to healthcare is a real problem, especially as the pandemic has shown, and at times when the cases have surged. Large parts of Africa and Southeast Asia continue to face challenges. In countries that have a low doctor-to-population ratio, doctors can treat many more patients if they are helped by AI. Soon, AI systems will reach the maturity to make diagnosis and treatment recommendations by themselves, increasing the healthcare access even further. But there's a problem. If there is even a single misuse or unintended consequence of the use of AI, a large number of people will be affected, and very quickly. Should we worry about this? Yes, of course. AI systems are difficult to test in all possible scenarios. For example, if you had used data approximately in this green and red region of the feature space to train the system to identify tumors, and now you present new data from somewhere in this blue region, then the AI system will not know how to respond and might give you an arbitrary response. That could be dangerous or disastrous in healthcare. These types of challenges can escalate quickly to pandemic-level crisis. And this might be a new type of healthcare crisis, a machine-based one. How do issues with AI become real? Well, take your personal health data, for example. It's stored, accessed, and used by AI. But what if some other bad actors, humans or machines, get access to it and sell it for profit? Another challenge is trust. Why should a patient trust the recommendation of an AI system? Can the AI system be transparent about its decision process and explain its conclusions? There are many more that we won't get into in this video. There are already examples of AI systems acting in a biased manner towards certain segments of the population. Who is responsible when an AI system makes a diagnosis recommendation and the patient dies? The AI system? The doctor? The CEO of the company which created the model? The technical architect? The data scientist? Or the data manager? All practitioners of AI in healthcare should be aware of these concerns and pay close attention to responsible use of AI. How do you get started in this seemingly complex problem space? Fortunately, help is available. Many organizations are working on addressing these concerns. The European Commission has just released a proposal for trustworthy AI. organizations like the World Economic Forum and the Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development have published frameworks focused on AI in healthcare. If you're developing or deploying AI in healthcare, these frameworks, which have been developed by multi-stakeholder groups, can give you a jumpstart. These free resources help reduce the risk in your AI deployments and make you a responsible AI proponent. By paying attention to responsible use of AI, taking advantage of the available resources, and working together, AI's full potential to help humanity can be realized, and you would have contributed towards that goal. This video was collaboratively created by Sundar Sundareshwaran and Raj Ramesh. Check out the links below for additional information and to get started. For a one-page visual summary of this video, please sign on to my website. Thank you deeply for giving me the motivation to do what I do.